Namaste from Divine Wellness. I'm Suyash.
And I'm Raina.
In this video, I'm going to show you the practices that come under Pavan Muktasana Series 3. Now, this series is also called the Energy Block Group of Practices, Shakti Bandha Asanas. Now, as the name suggests, energy block, the energy in the body that flows throughout our nadis and the vital channels, that energy gets blocked in certain areas, and with the help of these practices we release those blockages and facilitate free-flowing energy movement throughout the body. Now, as talking about the benefits, the first of all of course comes under the free-flowing of the energy through the body. Second is it enhances the spinal muscles, spinal alignment. It also tones, for women, it tones up the pelvic muscles and release the menstrual cramps. And it is also a very important practice that come under postnatal programs to regain the strength and the muscle tone in the pelvic region. Now, these were the benefits, but there are also a lot of contraindications and do's and don'ts for this practice that are like people who are suffering from heart condition or hernia, they should avoid these practices. And if they want to do, they should always consult an expert. But let's leave it for later, but we'll talk about it in detail. Rana is here to help us understand, and we will gonna mutually show you how to practice these asanas. The first practice that comes under this group is pulling the rope, Rajju Karshana Asana. Now, in this pose, we imagine an imaginary rope hanging in front of us, and there is a weight, that's also an imagination, there is a weight or a bucket filled with water is tied on the other end, and that's what we have to try and lift up. So it uses a lot of arm strength and shoulder strength. Please take a look. Sit in base position with feet together, arms on the knees, spine erect. Now make a fist with thumb inside and fingers curling over, and place the fist on the knees, elbows straight. Now visualize an imaginary rope hanging in front of you. Keeping the arm straight, start from the right arm and reach up the rope. Grasp the rope and with all the strength of your arm, pull it down. Repeat it with the left, alternating this movement for 5 times each side. Use the alignment, the awareness of the movement and the count to keep your awareness with the practice. Now, as you view from the front, you will notice the position of the fist should be right in front of the eye. As the fist moves up, the eyes follow the movement, resulting a slight raise of the chin in the final position. And then muscles contract and tighten up as you pull the imaginary rope and lift the weight on the other end of it. Always remember to keep the core strong as you lift the weight, as you move the arms up and down. Now, the dynamic spinal twist. This is the next practice that comes under Pavan Muktasana Series 3. As the name suggests, it is a dynamic movement of the spine in a twisting motion. As I say, it's a dynamic movement, so it should not be practiced by beginners because it may harm their vertebrae and the spinal disc, isn't it? So please take a look. We're gonna show you the demonstration.
Sit in base position with feet separated about a meter apart or a comfortable distance, palms on the knees and spine erect. Now slowly start to raise the arms to the sides at shoulder height. Make a fist and keep the arms in line as you swing to the right and left, breathing normally. As you move, as you swing to the sides, the arms should not miss the alignment. They should be in one line from the shoulders. Place the arms back on the knees as you finish the desired round.
Now the next practice that comes under Pavan Muktasana Series 3 is the churning the mill, Chakki Chalanasana. In ancient Indian villages, we used to have these two stone, huge stone kept on one on top of the other, and the women used to put these grains in between them and then they used to churn it. So by churning it, it used to bring the flour out. Now that is the motion, that is the, the practice imitates the motion of that same churning of the mill. That's why we name it so. Now, because you have to imitate the movement, you have to also put up a lot of strength and energy behind the movement. So that works with the upper body and the pelvic toning. Please take a look and get the idea.
Sit with feet separated about a meter apart and visualize that churning mill and hold the handle with making a fist with both arms, imitating the movement of a churning mill. Move from left to right in a clockwise direction, keeping the arms and elbows straight, preferably at shoulder height. Complete the desired rounds from one side and repeat the same number of rounds from the other side. And while moving, keep the torso and spine straight, because as you move the heavy stones of the churning mill, the vertebrae and the spine should be in safe position. Lower the arms when you finish the practice.
Nauka Sanchalan, rowing the boat. Now this is the next practice that is included in Pavan Muktasana Series 3. Now with this movement, by the imitation of rowing the boat, we contract and extend the abdominal and pelvic region. This way it releases a lot of energy and the energy blockages, and also tones this region. So it's good for the waist, strengthening the back and the arms and shoulders. Please take a look and get the idea.
Visualize imaginary oars of the boat and hold the oars with your fist with thumb inside. Now start to row the boat, bending forward with exhalation, and move back as you inhale. Now to row a boat, you need to pull and push the water forward and backwards. That requires a lot of energy from the arms and shoulders and the back. With the visualization of boat, the imaginary boat, we use the strength of the upper body and repeat the same number of rounds in the other direction. After a few rounds, you will start to feel the energy and heat in the pelvis. This is the release of the energy blockages, helping reproductive and gynecological problems and constipation and other digestive conditions. Now to finish the movement, bring the fist back to the shoulders and then put the palms back on the knees.
Now chopping of the wood. It is Kashta Takshanasana. Kashta stands for wood. Takshana means cutting off or chopping off. Now this movement and this imitation of this movement demands a lot of energy, and energy not only physically but mental and emotional. That is the reason why application of this pose is also used for emotional disturbances and people suffering from mental conditions. It releases aggression, releases negative or disturbing emotions, and facilitates free flow of energy through the body, mind, and of course emotions. Please take a look and get an idea.
Squat comfortably on the floor with arms between the knees and fingers of both hands clasped together. Imagine the action of a chopping wood. Keeping the elbow straight throughout the practice, raise the arms over the head and keep looking at the palms. Now with forcefully bring the arms down between the feet, making a ha sound with the mouth. This is one round. Repeat for 5 to 10 rounds. This practice loosens the pelvic, shoulder blade and back muscles, which are usually inaccessible.
Now, salutation pose. Now, this is the practice that we are going to do next. Namaskarasana. The movement involves a lot of stretching of the pelvic region. So, this is not a beginner's practice as such, although it belongs to this certain group where we prepare for advanced practices, but for this, for practicing this particular asana also, we need a lot of pelvic flexibility, back flexibility. So always an expert guidance is recommended, but still take a look to get an idea, and maybe you can use props or any sort of assistance, but always under expert guidance. That's what I would recommend.
Squat comfortably on the floor with arms between the knees and palms joined together in the gesture of prayer. Now this is the starting position. Inhale and slowly raise the chin up. Exhale and extend the arms in front, bringing the chin down into the throat pit. A stretch forward. Now with inhalation, come back to the starting position. This is one round. Practice 5 to 10 rounds, holding each round for 2 to 3 seconds. The head should synchronize the movement of the arms in each round, extending the back, shoulders and arms forward and then upward. This asana has a profound effect on the nerves, the muscles of thighs, knees, shoulders and arms. Increases the flexibility of the spine and the hips. When you finish, place the palms back on the knees.
When release pose, Vayu Nishkasana Asana. Vayu, wind, Nishkasana is elimination or release, and asana is the pose. So such a pose where we try and release and move the wind forward. That is the wind movement. There are five different major Vayus in the body, and each has different specific movement and direction. So we try and focus towards the lower abdominal, the region which is below the chest. So this the Vayu that is present here, the Apana, moves downwards, and this downward movement is facilitated with this asana. Now here again, flexibility of the pelvis and the thighs is very important. So take a look and see if you can try.
Squat comfortably with fingers sliding under the insteps and thumbs on top of the feet, elbows slightly bent and upper arms touching the inside of the knees. Keep the eyes open throughout the practice. Inhale and raise the chin up, elongating the spine upwards and look towards the ceiling. Exhale and raise the buttocks as you straighten the knees. Hold each position for a couple of seconds and accentuate the spine. Inhale and sit back in starting position. This completes one round. Now practice 5 to 10 rounds each time.
The next practice under Pavanuttasana Series 3 is Kavachalasana, the crow walking. As the name suggests, we walk imitating a movement of a crow, not flying but walking. So it also requires a lot of flexibility in the pelvis, knees, thighs, the whole of the lower body. So take a look and see if it's safe for you.
Squat comfortably with feet apart. Place both palms on the knees. Come on the toes as you start taking small steps forward, starting from left leg. Walk either on the toes or the soles of the feet, as is comfortable to you. As you take small steps forward, bring opposite knees down on the floor. Try to maintain the balance of the body and the movement.
Abdominal stretch, the Uddarakarshanasana. Now this is the pose which is included in the last phase of Pavanmuktasana series 3. Now as the name suggests, we stretch the abdomen without twisting the spine. Now it is only the contraction and churning of the front part of the torso. Now when you take a look, you will understand how we basically position ourselves in such a way that we do not lose the balance as well as we stretch the abdomen. A very important key point that I would like to mention here is this is one of the five practices that I included that are practiced for the Shankha Prachalana, one of the induced percussions that I am part of the detoxification practices of yoga. So watch carefully and see if you can try it.
Yeah. Squat comfortably with palms on the knees. With exhalation, guide the right knee down to the left foot on the floor. Push both knees towards each other, pushing them with your arms. Squeeze the abdomen in the final position and look over the right shoulder. Inhale as you return to the center and repeat on the other side. This completes one round. Each time practice 5 to 10 rounds.
All these practices involve pelvic flexibility. The pelvic flexibility, lower back flexibility, legs, all these things that involve stretching and contraction of the lower body. To be able to do such practices, one should be healthy, one should be strong enough not to sprain or get any sort of injury in the knee or the ankles. So these practices should not be done by people who are having any sort of injury in their legs, ankle, knee injury or a surgery, knee replacement, people had any sort of a multiple fracture in their legs or any such injury. Then the ladies who had surgical delivery or people who had lower abdominal surgeries for any such reason like hernia or anything. Then people who are suffering from any sort of acidic condition, gastroacidic condition, they should avoid this. Now heart patients, hypertensives, they should also avoid this. Now you might be thinking why it's because the heart is not in the abdomen, but because as I said in the very beginning while introducing you, this practice flushes a lot of energy throughout the body because the abdominal region is the place where we generate energy from, and from this abdominal region the energy rushes up to the extremities, and if that increased flow of energy reaches up to heart or the brain, they both are not very congenial for heart conditions, or for that matter, hypertensives. So such people should also avoid. But if they want to practice, they should always practice under expert guidance. And to find an expert, you should please log on to www.divinewellness.com. Practice safe, stay healthy. Namaste.